Greetings viewers, welcome back to the second Hard Enduro race analysis on the channel. Ironically, it's an analysis of the first race in the season, the Xross Hard Enduro in Serbia. In the first analysis, I confined my coverage to the top six finishers, but on this occasion, I've decided to favour riders with more eventful race stories. So for this one, I've dropped Graham Jarvis in favour of Billy Bolt. As you can see from the graph on the screen, I have a new additional method of presenting the race results. You can see from looking at the light blue line at the top, Graham's race was not that inspiring, as he steadily fell away from the leaders as the race progressed. By contrast, Billy was competitive throughout, but because of other problems, his finishing position didn't reflect his race performance. So later on in the video, the detailed breakdown of the race timings is still included. But for those who don't want to trawl through all that data, I'm now going to present a short race summary using the new graphs, which give us a very simple and clear method of analysing the riders' fortunes during the race. So first, a few tips on reading the charts. First, the race leader always coincides with the black horizontal axis, which luckily in this race is always Manny. The other five riders are represented by the coloured traces, which detail their progress in relation to the leader. As a result, you can see how the riders' fortunes fluctuate in comparison to the race leader and each other. You can quite clearly see how each rider gains or loses time for each individual stage. So taking each of the 3 days in turn, I'll take you through the race. First, here are the six riders we'll be discussing. In essence, the race was fairly straightforward. The riders fell into three competitive levels. Firstly, Manny and Billy, who maintained the fastest pace. Then Mario, who slipped steadily back from the two front runners into a class of his own. And thirdly, Theodore, Tristan and Michael, who had a race of their own even further back. This becomes evident just from looking at the graph for the first day. Unfortunately, riding to checkpoint 7, Billy loses his way, posts a time that is half that of the other riders, and he's giving a 45-minute penalty, which puts him into 10th place. The traces on the graph show that after an initial settling down period, the riders are generally on par with each other, but are slowly falling back in comparison to the leader, Manny. The graph for the second day shows that this trend continues, Billy being the only rider that consistently keeps pace with the leader. The other riders are only getting up to pace later in the day. Day 3 brings Billy more misfortune, when mechanical problems delay him by more than an hour. Apart from this drama, the race remains fairly static. Mario consolidates his second position, and Theodore emerges ahead from the three-way fight for third place. The contest for fourth between Tristan and Michael continues to the end. But because of a worse performance in the prologue, Michael needs to stay well ahead of Tristan. Luckily for him, Tristan gains ground, and although Michael regains fourth place before the end of the race, his advantage is not enough to offset Tristan's faster time set in the prologue, and so finishes fifth in the overall standings. If you want to go through the timings stage by stage, continue watching this video till the end. Bye for now, thanks for watching, see you again for Romaniacs 2023. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.